planned a few rides in the Gloucester area. The weather forecast for the 11th of July, middle of winter, was absolutely spectacular. So we headed late on the Tuesday to Singleton for the night to position ourselves for this day's ride, which was our ride to Gloucester. And this first part of the ride was what I really liked a few weeks ago, so we thought we'd do it again. And the second part of the ride from Gundy is one of Tony's favourite rides. So we put them together, and that's what we're doing today. I find this bitumen section really interesting. It's scenic, plenty of water crossings, the road's decent quality, and there's absolutely no traffic. In a short while we reach the road. We came this way to ride Bowman's Creek Road, and it's a gravel road, which is really interesting. It's just got so much going for it, loose gravel, bit of ruts and very undulating, a shitload of cow dung and the occasional kangaroo. This area is a really recommended and pretty easy riding experience, and this gravel section goes for a little bit over 20 kilometres. If you like a peaceful ride up and down hills and surrounded by rolling mountains, then this is where you'd come. It's actually not too different to the areas like the Barrington Tops. So here we are, enjoying this 4.5 day ride, and if you have a close look at Tony's bike, you'll notice she's got no luggage. So how could she have no luggage? Well, she decided that she would buy this Lone Rider soft panniers, which she thought were going to be a really good idea, and they're the ones that actually clip onto the existing BMW connectors, so you don't have to add any frames for them. So she thought that'd be a good idea and picked up a pair of them, loaded up the gear, put them on my bike, and I'm carrying the luggage, so that's okay, but that's why Tony's not carrying any luggage. You've got to really love this route. It provides picturesque scenery featuring expansive farmland and rolling hills that add to the beauty of the surroundings. I have to say, having done this a few weeks earlier, we probably enjoyed it a whole lot more. The riding was a little bit more fluent. We were a lot more confident on the road and still able to have a good look around as well. And when I mention now, the last part of today's ride was kindly recommended by somebody on our Facebook page, and it's to go and visit the Kia Ora lookout just outside of Gloucester. It's a great tip. It's funny because riding this section last time, Tony found herself on the right-hand side of that big rut on the in the middle and was a little bit challenged by that hill. This time she just raced up without even noticing it was the same spot. We saw a few photos of the Rouchal Uniting Church on the internet. It looked like a really red brick, so we thought we'd ride out and check it out and discover the bricks weren't very red at all. Continuing our ride, we took Hunter Road onto the Gundy General Store, where we stopped for a nice morning tea before venturing towards one of Tony's favourite ride areas over Barrington Tops, passing through the Tomalla and the Curricabark areas. When we rode this a few months ago, for the first few kilometres we followed a watering truck wetting down the road, and basically it tells us that the road's kept in really good condition and it's very easy riding. The biggest difference riding this time is that we're riding just a little bit later in the morning. Last time we left Scone, so we were here a lot earlier, and so that just means the sun is a little bit more in your eyes. We were also recognising we're nearing the area where Tony wanted to put the drone up and do a bit of footage, where we knew the cows, the cattle would be each side of the road, and the road just beautifully winds through the farmland. We were heading for the Gloucester Country Club, where we were going to stay for 3 nights, and that way we could do some out and back rides in the Gloucester area and finish up with a nice meal at the golf club, the country club there next door. One of the things about riding these areas is it's always interesting when you're not looking at the cattle or the crossing a little bit of water. It's just always got something to keep you interested in the road, in the area. Here we've got the cattle who are on the road, but there's a couple of kangaroos. Moving to Polyfogal Road, where we're now going to wind down towards the bottom of the valley. And this is another reason why it's just so likeable to ride around this area. It's not just a straight road going through the valleys all the time. It's windy roads, all different types of surfaces, which are always got something interesting. We were very blessed with virtually perfect weather, perfect riding weather. I don't think we saw a cloud for at least 4 days, and the sky today, typical, perfect, beautiful blue sky. There's only one gate to open and close if you're riding this route. You generally have time to stop for some photos, as you'll barely see a car or a truck for the entire ride. We're riding on the Midas EO7 Plus tyres, and they're pretty good. They're really good on this sort of gravel dirt roads. They're not great on wet roads. They're pretty quiet on the bitumen, and actually they're very good on dry bitumen too. Although you don't see many cars four-wheel drives, we're still very conscious of turning a corner and one possibly coming around the other way, and always a worry if someone's going to come around wide. After Moon and Flat, there's approximately 100 kilometres of this dirt gravel road before you'll reach the sealed section just before the Thunderbolts Way. Curricabark Road is just stunning, and Toni couldn't resist pulling out the drone for this section of the road. By now I'd done around 500 kilometres with these saddlebag panniers, the Lone Riders, and I'd have to say they've passed the test because I didn't even know they were on, so that's always a good thing. We continue to really enjoy this ride with the scenery constantly changing and keeping an eye out for the occasional cow darting across the road. After a short stint on Thunderbolts Way, we make a left on Bowman Farm Road, which shortly turns to gravel as well. This road provided a very peaceful bypass to the Thunderbolts Way section, where it goes through Barrington, the suburb of Barrington, before reaching Gloucester. Bowman Farm Road is a smooth gravel road with the occasional causeway crossings. At this particular time of the day, the dairy cows are making their way to the milking sheds, and their udders appeared to be full of the brim. And these cows seem to be really well trained. They were crossing the road, and they impressively paused for us to let us ride by. It was actually a good experience witnessing how this takes place for a farmer who has so many cows to milk. It's quite amazing. Yeah. We're riding along talking with one another, wondering when that line of cows is going to stop, but you might not have saw, but it keeps on going right up around the left-hand side off the road that we just passed. Now, Kia Ora Road takes us to our final stop, which happens to be the Kia Ora Lookout. Now, this is interesting because as we were winding around, you can see that bridge to the left there. We rode past that when we were down the bottom in the valley. And again, you don't get great ideas when looking at photos or even the video. But from the lookout, it was quite stunning